Thank you for coming back, everybody. We'll go ahead and get started, as is our normal routine for our rehearsals. I like to start just with a brief devotional. I thought that tonight we would start out with the very same thing that I started out with when I first started at Village Church at the very, very, very beginning, like the very first meetings that we ever had, the very first rehearsals that we ever had. And
wait, I muted you.
Okay. I'm back. Thanks, babe. Anyways, so from the very beginning, this has been an important thing that we've talked about. You know, maybe every year or so, we might go through these, this little PDF that I dropped in the chat. So if you have the ability to go to your chat and look at the PDF that I uploaded, there's actually two documents I uploaded. I uploaded a PDF and a JPEG of a Bible verse that we'll look at in a second. But the first thing is a PDF document. It's called 8 Things to Shape Our Ministry. And, you know, I thought it'd be good to revisit those things. If you've been in our ministry for a long time, then you've probably heard these. But if you haven't, then it might be new to you. And that's good. That's good. So if you can, it's not in the chat. Let's see. I have to put it on again. No, that's right. Okay. I'm going to. Right. You're muted, but I hear you through the wall, babe. All right. Here it comes again. Eight things to shape our ministry. So there it is. There it is. And I will also. So take a look at that PDF, and then later we'll look at this Bible verse, and just yell at me if you can't see those things later. But okay, so 8 things to shape our ministry. We're just going to look at the first one today. And although I do appreciate Christy muting everyone, I was thinking that we might actually have a little more, just not a lot, but just some interaction here. So I don't know if
I just pushed allow them to unmute themselves.
Mom, you also muted Dad.
Okay. I'm back. This isn't our first Zoom meeting, you guys.
I'm sorry. I forgot how to do everything.
Stop acting like it's your first Zoom
meeting. I forgot how to do everything.
Now that Nathaniel's here, maybe we should make him the co-host again or something. Okay.
Yeah, good point.
So maybe now you can unmute yourselves if you want to pipe in. But let's take a look at this very first thing. It's just one thing to discuss here tonight. It's the very first thing that says it's all about Jesus. And I thought, you know, when I was making these things up, I thought this is the first thing because it's the most important thing. And so you can, I'll just read out loud what I have here in case you can't access the PDF. I put just a little bit of text underneath this thing. But as we think about ministry and as we think about our choir, as we even move forward from here, I always want us to have that in the back of our heads that it's all about Jesus. Okay, it's not about me. It's not about you. It's not about anybody else. Let me read this though. Your motivation for serving in ministry must be Christ and Christ alone. Any and all other motivations will fade over time. Okay, like being fun or the fulfillment that you get from singing. All that, any other motivation other than Christ will wane, okay? It will fade away. So over time, you know, I'm gonna go back to reading here. If you're going to sing or play because it brings you personal fulfillment or pleasure, eventually over time, the personal fulfillment and pleasure will fade. Ministry is hard work. Can I get an amen? The only way to do it so it will last is to do it all for Jesus. So as we think about, as you think about, it's all about Jesus and that idea of Jesus being our motivation and our desire. What kind of things pop into your mind? What are some things that what does that mean to you when we say it's all about Jesus? Feel free to unmute and chime in if you want.
It's all about praising him and sharing him with other people and drawing other people into the worship service.
Good. Yes.
It's not about where I do that or, you know, how big that church is or how small that is or what kind of modern song this is or what kind of old hymn it is, you know, like it's all for Jesus. So none of that matters. And so you just kind of can strip away a lot of those concerns.
Absolutely. That's exactly right. It doesn't matter if you like the song or not. Oh, go ahead. Anybody else?
It doesn't matter if I'm the center of attention or if I'm just singing. Mm-hmm. It doesn't matter if my ideas are used or not. It is not about me.
Awesome.
I think it's the why we're doing what we're doing. We're doing it to glorify Christ and to see him being exalted to the highest place that he deserves to be at. So all of our motivations, raising our kids, our working, anything we need to do, anything we do, we're supposed to be doing it for the glory of Christ and not for ourselves, not to be seen, but for him to be seen more clearly.
Mm. Awesome. Yeah. I feel like there's a couple other people that were going to say something.
Noel said it for me.
Okay, I will speak. No matter how frustrating the song can be, because I had a few moments, because I've been singing as long as I've been singing, and sometimes I just couldn't get it. But when I stopped trying to do it perfectly and remember, this is not about me, it's all about Jesus, I'll just turn it in. Those videos were really hard. So it was like, Daniel, I might've hit the note, I might not have, but I enjoyed the song.
Amen. And
so because I put the focus back on Jesus, I was like, here, this is what I'm presenting to you today.
Amen.
Awesome. Yeah, that's exactly right. Sometimes we can get too wrapped up in how we're serving or what we're doing to forget why. You know, and to forget the reason behind it all. It's not about, you know, me at any time. Is it about me? In fact, I probably would not have chosen to put myself on camera at all during the Christmas concert unless I felt like I had to make those weird announcements. Or, you know, in fact, Christy, you know, when we were going to talk about all the rules we followed for the COVID restrictions for the orchestra, like the 5 minutes of at the very beginning, I said, Christy, can you just do this? And she's like, no, it has to be you, you know, you're the director. And I was like, okay, fine. But, you know, you're right. Ben said it just right. You know, it's not about being the center of attention or whether you're a little square on the, you know, where you appear on the square of the video, if you're in the top corner or the bottom or the middle or where, and, you know, like it, or whether your solo got picked or didn't, you know, all those things, they're all just, like, meaningless. What's really important is that you show up here to serve Jesus and that you are sacrificing and giving your and bringing your offering to him. That's what's awesome. And in our service, you know, sometimes we think we have this big, you know, Christmas show to do, or we have this big concert or whatever it is, this big thing coming up, you know, or Easter that we're going to be looking towards now, and we think that's the goal, this big show or this big thing. But, you know, a lot of times what God does in us while we're working on the show is just as important as whatever he is going to do through the show. So we get to be a part of the journey as well. We get blessed by sacrificing and serving and putting Christ at the center of our lives every single week. So that's how I wanted to start today. Oh, there is a little Bible verse to look at. Let's look at this Bible verse together. That was also dropped into the chat. If you didn't see it, you can look it up. It's the very last chapter of John. And this will be quick. And then we got a lot of songs to start listening to tonight, a lot of new music. But the last book of John, or the last chapter of the book of John, and I'm in verse 15. This is Jesus meeting up with Peter right before he basically, you know, right at the end of John. Verse 15, when they had finished eating, Jesus said to Simon Peter, Simon, son of John, do you truly love me more than these? Yes, Lord, he said, you know that I love you. Jesus said, feed my lambs. Again, Jesus said, Simon, son of John, do you truly love me? He answered, Yes, Lord, you know that I love you. Jesus said, take care of my sheep. The third time he said to him, Simon, son of John, do you love me? Peter was hurt because Jesus asked him the third time, do you love me? He said, Lord, you know all things. You know that I love you. Jesus said, feed my sheep. Now, a lot of times I've heard this scripture read from a pastoral point of view, from people that are pastors, that this passage, you know, encourages them and motivates them as they are loving and feeding their flocks, you know, as they're preaching the word or shepherding their flocks, which I totally get. But I almost wanted us to use this as an encouragement for us as we're forging ahead in this ministry now. You know, as we think about this, instead of what if we read this scripture again, and instead of Simon, son of John, you put your name in there, right? Like this, when Jesus said to Daniel, Daniel, son of Walter, do you truly love me more than these? And yes, Lord, I said, you know that I love you. Jesus said, feed my lambs. And what if you, okay, so every one of you, I want you to read along with me and just put your name in there instead of Simon, put your name in from verse 16. Again, Jesus said, Daniel, son of Walter, do you truly love me? And I answered, yes, Lord, you know that I love you. Jesus said, take care of my sheep. The third time he said to him, Daniel, son of Walter, do you love me? Daniel was hurt because Jesus asked him the third time, do you love me? I said, Lord, you know all things. You know that I love you. And Jesus said, feed my sheep. So we have, I just was reading that today and thinking, you know, there are a lot of people in our congregations and on YouTube or in Facebook or wherever they're going to find these songs that are going to be fed by our ministry, the things that we do here, the songs that we sing, and the notes that we learn as we rehearse, they are going to be fed by you through Christ and your ministry here. So my extreme thankfulness, my gratefulness to all of you for participating and keeping on going through this great thing. You rock. You're awesome. Woo. Okay. So now, hey, let's look at some new music tonight. Okay. This is, we're going to start with a song called Psalm 23. I am not alone. And so let's see, I will share my screen. Hopefully you have an iPad near you with this music loaded in it, or you were able to get it on Planning Center and print it out. If there is anybody having trouble with sheet music, you know, drop us a line. You can leave a note in the chat even right now, or feel free to email me. You know, Ashley has gotten a big job, and so she's not answering all those Village Choir emails, but I am. So you can send me a note if you want to. I'm also much less busy since I don't have to edit a video every week now. So that's helpful. But okay, so let's see. Let's all mute ourselves and I will go over to share my screen. We're gonna listen to some music, you guys. Okay, everybody have this song up called I Am Not Alone. So I'll go ahead and sing along at home. I want to just tell you, no, I'm not going to say anything. We're just going to listen. Here we go. I'll tell you later.
Filled with unknown. Your spirit.
Yeah, a lot of beautiful stuff in there. What a powerful thing to sing. I am not alone. Yeah, just gorgeous. If you have to extra time, Google this name of this song, Psalm 23, I Am Not Alone. And there's like a YouTube of a live performance out there with a big choir and like a church somewhere. And there's a guy singing a solo along with it. And it's just like, just tears, like this is gorgeous. It's just wonderful. So I did ask Shai to sing some of those, like in those holes, some ad-libs and things. Also notice that just on a musical side, once we get to page 9, the altos really are carrying the melody the rest of the song. Sopranos jump to a higher harmony, but so altos, grr, like, you know, take it babies, take it altos. All right, good. So going over now to a different of a super fun song called He Walked Out. This is a fun, exciting song. This was a Christy pick. She loved this one and she showed it to me and I was like, yes please. So let's check it out. He Walked Out.
Oh,
Woohoo. Okay, I just figured out something. Christy and Nathaniel are alerting me that I have not shared my computer audio, which is why it sounds bad. I'm sorry.
Thank you.
Yes. Nathaniel.
I
thought we couldn't hear it if we shared the computer audio.
Listen, I'm telling you, that song would sound much better if it sounded better. I went out into the other room and I'm like, well, that sounds really good. Why did I like this song again? It'll sound better when you can hear it the whole way.
All right. Well, here we go. Share sound. See, adults on Zoom. You guys. Adults on Zoom. All right. Okay. All right. Now this next song I'm sure will sound even better now that we're doing. Okay. Go over. Okay. That's a dynamite song though. If you haven't listened to that on Planning Center, listen to it. The reason I showed you those first two songs is I think, you know, in this order is these will probably be some of the earlier songs that we'll record in thinking towards Easter and some other releases online and whatnot. So these are songs that are, I would use the word attainable and, you'll still want to obviously rehearse them and learn them, but you know, they're repetitive enough so that, like, you know, it'll be a little easier than some of the other songs we'll rehearse tonight, which will take a little more work, which I know you're not scared of, because you guys did, you know, a beastly amount of work for Christmas. I mean, I think we did 15 songs in 14 weeks or something ridiculous. So this, you'll be fine. Don't get scared. Okay, I want to go over now to another great song called Sing the Story Hallelujah. All right, Sing the Story Hallelujah. This one, I'm just going to tell you up front that I love this song. My favorite part is the part that's like the last three or four pages where it does one of those things that I love where like the sopranos go sing a thing and they repeat it. And then like the tenors come in on their own thing that they repeat. And then the altos jump in on a totally different, you know, like one of those things where everyone's singing something different. It just sounds like a glorious, beautiful thing. It's one of those moments that you don't get anywhere, but you know, in choir. But that comes towards the end. Great song. Let's look at it now. It's called Sing the Story Hallelujah. And I bet it's going to sound much better than my apologies. Okay, here we go.
Peace who came.
need to pause. I know you're vibing with the song and everything, but I want you to just think, as we're singing through, those eighth notes are they're almost like double long. They're very long eighth notes. Hallelujah. Okay, like this definitely not hallelujah. So just think long on these eighth notes that are at the ends of phrases where there's a rest that follows it. Hallelujah to Christ. So you give good due diligence to that eighth note. You know, you're hanging on to it so we don't cut it off too short. Just as we're sight reading, I know. Okay, we're going on, moving on. We're somewhere around measure, I think 32-ish.
Sacrifice for sinners saved. But on that morning, just as he promised, the Lamb of God rose from the grave. Jesus, the Lamb rose from the grave.
Yeah, those eighth notes are, I mean, if I was being precise, they'd be eighth notes tied to eighth notes. Hallelujah, again and again. If you're listening for it, you're kind of counting along, you'll notice they're long notes. They're more than an eighth note. So, all right, okay. But just, we want to make sure we emulate that same thing as we sing and follow along so we're not chopping these eighth notes. It'll sound really bad. If we sing hallelujah, all heaven sing hallelujah, like that's just going to sound terrible. We want to give nice long notes. So just thinking about that as we move forward. Okay, we're at the bottom of page 9, measure 57, I think is where I paused it as we key change here. Amen. The end is great, right? With that fun stuff. Yeah, super, super duper. All right, you guys are awesome. We're going over now to a song called Glory. All right, it's called Glory. This is gonna a big change of gears from the last song we sang. This one's a lot of fun. There's I like the note at the very beginning. It says, everyone clap freely. Clapping in time on each beat works too. All right, so thanks, Phil Nitz. He's actually a really funny guy. Good guy. Clapping in time works too. All right, here we go. Okay, so here's in my mind as I'm already thinking about the fun video that this is gonna be. I want you to think about, here's what I'm thinking. I love the clapping. We really can't sing and clap at the same time, you guys, okay? Like, all the other people, you gave me that. It's just, all we're gonna hear is clapping. It'll be a mess, it'll be terrible. But I would love to be able to salt and pepper in some videos of you guys clapping, you know, but you won't be singing while you're clapping. So it'd be like maybe a second video of you like, you know, and doing fun, creative things, you know, so it's not just like everyone's standing there, you know, with this frowny face, like just clapping, you know, something fun, you know. I want you to think about the Christmas show, you know, there were a certain fun elements that made some songs really come to life in the video, right? So the song where Ben was dancing as the Christmas tree was just like standout hilarious, right? But that's the risk of, right, me saying, Ben, would you dance in a Christmas tree costume? And he's like, sure, you know, and you guys don't know, maybe you do know, he did three whole takes of that, three whole times through in like 15 minutes, right? One right after the other. And by the end, he was like drenched in sweat, like, you know, just because he gave it his all dancing on the Christmas tree. And that made that video hilarious, right? There was the medley where everyone's changing all their costumes and their sweaters and their hats and everything. And I saw those and pulled them all out, you know, in those transitions and put them up there for people to see. And people loved it. I mean, people were commenting, oh my gosh, I loved the video where everyone was changing their outfits. It was hilarious. You know, little tiny things like that can make a song come to life, you know, especially when we're in this visual medium and we're not, you know, staring at a riser's full of choir. So, you know, it'd be fun to get some videos of us, you know, clapping, and I can kind of intersperse those and you know, of course, smiling while you're clapping and smiling and having fun, and then we are also singing the song. So not that it has to be goofy or corny or even funny necessarily, but I think to be able to put those elements in will bring the song to life and bring joy to people that are listening. You know, it'll do that. So that's coming. All right.
Lift it up, say, lift it up to the name above. Trust, marvelous.
Oh, to the one.
To the one who is everywhere. And he's answering every prayer, always there.
nobody like you, Lord.
Oh, hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah.
Oh, hallelujah. There's nobody like you. Oh, hallelujah. There's nobody like you. Oh, hallelujah. There's nobody like you, Lord.
It is. It's so much fun. Yeah. And, you know, it's another one of those ones that's kind of repetitive enough so that, you know, if you listen to it a lot on your phone or on your computer or CD or whatever, you'll get it. You'll get it fast. It's a lot of unisons and then there's some parts and just tons of fun. Love that groove. Okay. There is another song I want us to look at. This one is one of the more like beastly songs. It's this one will take some hard work on everybody's part to learn this one. And I want to just listen to it tonight before we go. It is awesome and like awe inspiring. It's called Psalm 24. Psalm 24. This is one that's like very minor-ish. Sometimes we call this angry praise. It's angry praise because it's minor, but it's not. It's actually very beautiful. Beautiful song. I very just fell in love with it right away.
Thank you.
Right. What a powerful song. What a stark contrast to, you know, we give you the glory, Lord. You know, very both awesome songs, but in two different, totally different ways. So, yeah, this one, Psalm 24, really struck me. Not only was it powerful and bold, and it's scripture, so that was amazing as well. But it just struck me as really fun to sing, because unlike the repetitive songs, every time we were to get to a new phrase, it was like we turned a new corner and there's something else happening in this song. You know, we're halfway through and we get to a new section. It's in 6-4, you know, and then, we key change and we key change again, but we key change down. And then, like, it's just all this really fun, incredible, musically rich things that are happening in this song. So I thought, man, for the musician, this is fun to sing, but also it's a blast to listen to. So, and it's scripture. It's just all around a winner. It really is. It really is. So, okay, I didn't get to two songs tonight, but that's okay. Let me do this. Stop my screen share. I didn't get to Christ is Risen, but you can, of course, take a listen to those on Planning Center. I also didn't get to Surrounded. This is how I fight my battles. The one thing I'll say about Surrounded that I really like is that they took a song that is very repetitive and they added layers to it to make it not quite as like just the same thing over and over again. Although the ladies sing a little bit of that for a while, but like men and women are doing different things, and it's really fun. And there's a cool track to that song as well. So hope you guys are loving that. But my there's no song due next week, right? Hallelujah. So yay. But what I do want you to do is to start listening to these songs on your own while as you're at home, if you are driving anywhere, or maybe just listen to them on your desktop audio as you're working from home or whatever. But you I want you to make sure you have all the tools that you need to be rehearsing these songs well. So if that means you need to write me an email or put a note in the Church Center app that says, I can't find the music, or can you help me, you know, get the MP3s? I'm happy, of course, to help in any way to equip you with the tools that you need for success. The last thing I want is for the deadline of one of these songs to come up and you to be like, frightened in front of your camera trying to sing this song because you feel ill prepared, and that was a result of me not giving you what you needed. So all the MP3s and practice tracks are all online now. You can listen to your alto or tenor or bass or soprano tracks that are starting right now today. And the regular MP3s are there as well as all the choir sheet music. So you should have everything to get you going to start rehearsing. And I do want to hear about, hopefully you have the Church Center app on your phone still. I know many of you were using that well at Christmas to put prayer requests or to chat with each other, and love that we're still using that for prayer requests. One of the best things we can do is pray for each other and lift each other up to the Lord. That's something we'll talk about next week in our eight things to shape our ministry. You know, the second one is about prayer. So anyways, speaking of prayer, I will close us tonight. And then, you know, by next week, you'll have listened to all these songs and rehearsed them. And we'll sing some more together next week and talk about when our first song will be due. But it's not now. So you have some time. Don't panic. Just start that rehearsing going. Start that practicing on your own time. So let me close this in prayer. We just have a couple of minutes left here tonight. So let's pray together. Would you bow your heads with me? Lord Jesus, we come before you and we're so grateful for the gifts that you've given us, for the many blessings that you've given us, even in this time where the world is dark and crazy. We know that everything good that we have is a gift from you. So we are grateful for that, Lord. Help us to keep that perspective always that God, you are good and you are faithful, and we give you glory and we give you praise. Jesus, now as we go and do this rehearsing on our own, just help us, Lord, to remember to do that and to be diligent in our practice. And God, just thank you so much, Lord, for just the amazing way that you blessed our Christmas concert, and just the many thousands of people that watched and left comments about you know, their spirits being lifted and being ministered to. We give you all the glory for that, Lord. We know that it happened because of you and what you did and not anything that we did. We just came before you to bring our offering and to serve. And that's what we do again in this new year. We come to serve and to love you and worship you. It's in your name I pray all of these things. Amen. Amen.